Hello. So, I decided to live stream this the creation of this blog post because I think that it's never I never do enough to explain how this entire thing works. It's actually it's pretty complicated, but if you know what to do, actually it's like step-by-step process. You just have to be a little bit creative. So, I have this website that I started about 6 months ago. In 1 week exactly, it's gonna be 6 months, and it has been going pretty well. So I show you now my analytics. These are my analytics, and this is today. I will just refresh. Boom. So you see that it's live, and you see I had a peak of traffic last week, and this was on Tuesday, yes. And you see that I start to see every weekend on a Saturday we have a dip, and this leads me to think that these people, my visitors, are people which are working and they use internet at work to search for information about vacation. So my website is about the Leaning Tower of Pisa. These people are dreaming of going to Italy, and they search while they're working. So on a Saturday, nobody's working and my traffic goes down. So this is my idea of what's happening here. But you see, most important thing here is that the traffic has been growing like constantly for a while, and then it started to ramp up. And now we are in a place where I expect it to go up even more. Now, don't look at this. This is just today. So we have 31 visitors. This is organic traffic. You see it here, right? So this is a little bit the background story. Now, what I'm going to do right now, I'm gonna write another article to add to the website. I have, I think, at the moment 12 articles or something like that. And the traffic they're bringing, so let's go a little bit deeper here in the analytics. So I want to select 30 days. Think I have to pick 11 because February has 28 days, so more or less. I had 1,878 visitors, organic visitors, in the last month, in the last 30 days. Now, this is a brand new website, and this number, it's kind of a lot of visits. And one thing I want to show you is the time on page. We don't look at this. Where is it? This average session duration. This is like bullshit because I don't know how it's calculated, but I mean, it's calculated, takes into account the bounce rate, and the bounce rate here is pretty high because usually people come to visit one page that satisfies their question and then they leave. So if I go on site content and all pages, you can see, look at the time on page, look, 25 minutes, 20 minutes. If we order it like this, 34 minutes. So this is average time on page. People spend half an hour looking at these pages. This is why I'm ranking this well, because the engagement is really, really high and Google can see that. So this happens when you write something that really provides value to people and satisfies their search intent, right? So what is the search intent here is to find information. So they have a question, they're curious about something, and then they come to the page, and basically what happens, they read the page and they leave it open on their browser for going back later to read and even more. Maybe they want to browse some other pages. I don't know, but these pages are left open on the browser for sure. So this is something really cool that I've never seen before. I mean, average time on page is like 4 minutes, 6 minutes, but I've never seen like half an hour. This is really something awesome. So now, question here is how? So you see, I have these facts, and all the articles I made so far are meant to address a specific question. So if the page will ever load, I can show you. Okay, so, and I answered to questions like why the Leaning Tower of Pisa does not fall, how tall is the Leaning Tower of Pisa, Why is the Leaning Tower of Pisa leaning? How many steps are in the Leaning Tower of Pisa? So just all these pages rank on page number one if you Google for these titles, these questions, okay? And maybe some rank on really position number one, some are like position number four, but they're doing really well. Now, I want to add another article here. So basically, I want to add another question. And which one am I going to pick? Now, I'm going to show you a very interesting way to find out what your audience is looking for. And this makes use of your analytics. So before we go into that, I want to do something. I already opened all my tabs here, the tabs that I might need later during the making the article. By the way, this thing will take a couple of hours, so I'm going to live stream for a couple of hours. I hope you have time. If you don't have time, this thing will stay, this video will stay on the YouTube channel. You can go watch it later. But anyway, so I want to close these tabs because these are tabs that I have always open here, let's say my working tabs. But right now I need to use the tabs that I have here, and I don't want to use too much memory. So I'm gonna use this extension, Fresh Start, and I'm gonna save this session here, like temp I already have. Edit. I will I think it's this one here, window 48, yes. And I will kill this and save it. So now I have saved 16 tabs under this session. I can close this and I can reopen it later. This extension is really, really cool because I can just freeze what I'm doing, start doing something else, and then come back to that without having 3,000 tabs open. So now let's go into analytics. So to do this, to search for keywords, I go in acquisition, search console, and queries. Now to see this page, you must have linked Google Analytics to Google Search Console. If you haven't done that, this is empty, and you got a reminder here that you have to connect them. And you always have to browse this page when you are in all users, otherwise you don't see anything. So you see here all users, it works. Now let's take a couple of months of statistics. You see that for the last 2 days you don't get anything because these queries are not processed yet. So we'll take let's say from 10th of January to 10th of March. Actually, February is 28th, January is, I think it's from 9th. There should be 60 days, so apply. We don't need to be too precise. So these are the queries that came in, the impressions that my website made. Here you have it, impressions. This is number of clicks. And this is volumes. This comes from a plugin which is called Keywords Everywhere, and you have it here. Really good plugin because it gives you the search volumes. Search volumes, they are not exact, but it gives you an idea of which keywords bring more traffic and which keywords bring less traffic. So, and so it adds these three columns here. Now, what we want to do, we want to search for keywords, for queries that people use to get to the website, keywords that generated a number of impressions, but I don't have a page for that, okay? So something that has been ranking, but there is no specific page addressing that question, okay? How do we do that? We simply sort this thing by impressions. And then we start to check here. We have to show more, so I will show 2,500. Let's be generous. And I will start to read one by one all these queries. These are key phrases that people use to reach my website, or better, to generate an impression in the search result page. Now, I need to find one for which I don't have a page, and I already know which one is it. So all this like Lean Tower Pisa built, I have a page on when the tower was built, where is the Lean Tower, I have it, when the steps, I have it, how tall is it, I have it, who designed it, I have it. Let's see. There it is. So the first page, that the first key phrase that has a decent number of impression, and I don't have a page for it, is this one here. What is the Leaning Tower of Pisa made of? I don't have a page for this. Okay, so this is a very specific question. They want to know which material they used to build the Leaning Tower, and I don't have a page that addressed this even marginally. I mean, somewhere is written that the tower is made of marble, but it's just one sentence in a larger page. And you see this thing here, this query has a quite a good number of searches, which again, they are estimated, they are not true. And I generated almost the same amount of impressions. So this tells me somehow that there is no page ever that is addressing this question, because every time they ask this question, one of my pages makes an impression. Okay, so that's a really logic way of thinking here, right? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to just Control C this, copy it, and then I go here and just Google it. And oops, sorry, Control V. Yeah, see here you have other questions that Google is suggesting, and it's good to copy this for further use. But right now, let's just Google this, and I will go to get my mouse. I forgot to get it. Now I'm going with a finger. I don't particularly like that. Yeah, I'm back. Mouse. So, boom. Now, what we want to do, we want to understand how good are these pages that are ranking for this thing. So, the first one is this. We open it in another tab. Then we have the second, the third. This is okay. This .net, these are two are the same website. Then we have Wikipedia. I don't open Wikipedia because I know already it's pretty general. And then we have this, and then there is one of my pages, you see. So basically I have to outrank my own page that says why Pisa Leaning Tower does not fall. Okay, I'm pretty sure there is no mention of material here, like marble. I don't know why I'm even ranking. Maybe because my search history. Let's make another thing look. Let's make another thing. Let's kill all of this, and let's repeat the search in incognito. So you should always do like this. Sorry, I didn't do it before. But you see, in the process, I remember. So now we do it again. This won't change, but probably my own website won't be at number five anymore. Yes, you see, it's not. So the results I was seeing before were biased by the fact that I was logged in. I am logged in with my Google account. All right. So I've been opening now a bunch. Let's see how well these pages satisfy the search query. And again, the search query here is, what is the Leaning Tower of Pisa made of? Okay. is not a particularly long page, and it talks about history of the tower. So if I made is not even written nothing here. Let's say if I find marble, yep. So all the there it is here. The tower was built with limestone and lime mortar, though the exterior of the tower is covered in marble. Okay, so this paragraph here is talking about the construction, the materials, but it's just a little paragraph. Okay, so this is good. Then Wikipedia, Wikipedia has a lot of blah blah blah, but I think it's relevant. When a page, when you see Wikipedia ranking in the first page, it's good. It means that Google doesn't have anything better to show, so you can outrank that, even if it's Wikipedia, especially if it's Wikipedia. So now let's check this out. Again, marble, and there is nothing like marble here. Made, there is absolutely nothing about construction, and this is number two already. No, sorry, not number, there was Wikipedia, yes. So this is number three. Number three has nothing about the construction, the materials. Good. Can I outrank that? Number four, control F, made, there is nothing, marble, there is nothing. I think this is like, let's try stone. Yeah, okay, there is something about stones being laid on soft ground. Yeah, it's like very short paragraph. It's even a short page. So this is no match. The first one is lines always set. Okay, this is like, okay. Control F, marble. And there is only one match. Stone. There is only one match. So this is it. And the page is short. So no match for this. Construction overview of the Leaning Tower of Pisa. This looks to be a quite good page in construction. Yeah, so let's find marble. Yep, it's the same information that you find in the other articles. Nothing more. Okay. So I have a baseline. So you see, doing this exercise, when you start to write an article, you understand what which pages are available, how long they are, which kind of information they give, and how it well satisfies the search intent. And you understand what Google thinks that should rank. This is very important. This is, you understand what Google thinks is the search intent. So it's clear that the search intent here is to know about the material. So I say that none of this page is a match, and I say let's make these people happy, shall we? So let's write something that outranks all of this. How do we do that? Let's keep this page up. I'm gonna check if the live stream here is even working. Oh yes, it is. I have no people watching, which is fine. Very happy with that, so people don't see if I screw up. But of course you can watch the video when it's online, whatever. All right, so I'm gonna open a document. I use Joomla. I don't use WordPress, but that doesn't change much. So I will go in my articles, you might have a different interface, but in the end of the story, you are writing content on a content management system. Today, it's really slow. Why is that? Okay, so I'm gonna take the last article I wrote, which was written 10 days ago. This, by the way, it's ranking on page one as well. How is the Leaning Tower of Pisa inside? How awesome is that? Jesus, so slow. Now, first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna duplicate this, save as a copy, boom. It's really annoying that I have to wait so much. Stop it and save as a copy. Will you manage? Maybe because I'm streaming? I have no idea. So, but while we are waiting, I want to check. I saw before something really interesting when I was. Yes, so. You see that Google suggest is giving other variation of this query. What is the Leaning Tower of Pisa made of? What rock is the Leaning Tower of Pisa made from? That's not. So I duplicated this twice apparently, but so it doesn't matter. I will kill the URL. I will take this and I will use it in the title here. So this is gonna be capital letters. What is the Leaning Tower of Pisa made of? What is the Leaning Tower of Pisa made of? There's no need to make it shorter or different. This is the question. So now, I'm gonna type right here this question. Just said. I can use them later. So, what is the Leaning Tower of Pisa? What is the materials? This is the one. What rock is the Leaning Tower of Pisa made from? I don't like from. Of what rock and what stone? Okay, so what rock is the Leaning Tower of Pisa made, and what stone is the Leaning Tower of Pisa made? So these two different key phrases can be used in the text to give relevance to the page, because Google knows that people are looking for also this questions, right? So if I answer them in the page, that's a great advantage. Let's see if I can find more. You see, I'm trying to make some very precise research before I start writing, because when I start writing, I just write and everything is already in the page. Why was it, what type of rock? Okay, what type of rock is the, what is the foundation? I don't care about the foundation right now. What type of rock? Yes, type of rock. So let's see if we have some other in the bottom of the page in searches related to, you can find other queries that work well with this. So Leaning Tower of Pisa inside, I already answered that. The facts out all, these are all different queries, so I'm not gonna use this. I think I can close this page. This I need. You see, I know already that I want to talk about marble, so I found some picture where that I can put in the article, which show where some of the marble was taken. Now, since I can speak Italian, and because I'm Italian, I'm gonna search this in Italian as well and see if I can find more information in the original language of the tower. I'm sure there is more. So if I Google che cosa fatta la Torre di Pisa, this means which material is used to build the Tower of Pisa, and I take this article that I have seen before, is again, they're all in Italian, so you probably don't understand, but what I'm looking for information that I can take in Italian and reuse in English. So this is very efficient use of my skills and time. Okay, I would write for marmo, which is marble. Nothing interesting. Looking for, looks like. I'm trying to find, so that you don't get bored there, I'm trying to find from which places this marble came from. You see that, look at this picture, there's like different types of marble in the tower, and they come from different places, because at the time where when the tower was built, Pisa was like, they were fighting over the sea. They were like, I don't know. They were kind of very powerful city. They had a fleet of ships, and they were going to fight wars to get lands and to conquer other cities. So they were like taking treasures and even monuments from the cities they were conquering and bringing them to Pisa. So they dismantle entire cathedrals and rebuilt with the construction material they were like harvesting. And this is how the tower was built. Boom, 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 boom. And now I can't find these places, whatever. We'll just make it up. More or less, I know what. Okay, I will try another here. The dove proviene il marmo della torre di Pisa? Where the marble of the Leaning Tower of Pisa come from? Yep, I think it's this one. So this is a local newspaper. Yeah, here. Okay, I can use this piece to include in the article. So I will just copy paste here so that I remember I have to use it. And now what I'm going to do, I'm going to put down the structure of the article. So what am I going to say and in which order? I think this article should be at very least like 700 words because they're pretty short, so I can get away with some shorter article. So if I make 5 points, then I need to write 150 words in each bullet point under each title. So let's start here. So I have something here in the intro, and then I start with, now I need to think, so I will stop talking and you can see here what is that I'm doing. Oh, this thing, by the way, it's not published, unpublished, so I'm just working on the back end. We'll save it just to be sure I'm not losing anything. So one thing you should know is that, especially in the titles, you should make use of what is known as power words. What are power words? They are like they are words that give emotions. And I have a list here that I've been using. You see, most of the list of power words. 317 emotion-packed words and phrases that will instantly make you a better writer. This is kind of cool. So I use now stunning. I don't even know if it's in this page. Stunning. Yes, stunning. To encourage and energize. See? So if you use these words, people are more, readers are more likely to stick with the piece of content, and this is exactly what I'm doing. Stunning white beauty. It's not entirely made of marble. And I'm gonna have to say that this marble comes from different locations. sociedad. It's a patchwork piece of art, right? It's patchwork. Patchwork, is it? Yeah, so let's go define patchwork and see if I'm patchwork define. Yeah. Can go. Can I put a power word in there? Nah, let's not overdo it. A patchwork piece of art. Then I would go with the. So they've been restoring the tower for past 10 years. There's been quite many works. So perhaps I want to talk a little bit about that. Because no, works are related to the materials. So we are talking about marble. Marble tends to get really gray in this in the polluted air of the city, so they had to restore it, and so they made some works that, why not talk about that? Picture piece of art. Saving the white beauty I already brought there. I don't know what to write here. Restoring its original beauty, I sent here. Look. Oh. No. All right, so let's say that this is cool like this. Take the gallery and paste it up somewhere. Here, blah 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 blah, and this is my paragraph. Oops, didn't copy it. Just getting ready to edit this thing. blah blah blah, even here. So this is gonna be headline 2, heading 2. So don't make mistakes of using the wrong headings. Headings are important. You want to have only H1, heading 1 on the page, and mine is in here. If you click on a article, show you, this is my H1 here, and everything that comes down here is H2. And this article, I don't even have it. This is one of the first articles I wrote. It's even pretty short, but anyway, so only one H1 on the page. Okay, don't mess with that. So this is H2, and so I have 4 bullet points, 4 titles, and then basically I can kill all the rest here up to the very end. Boom. Okay, so now again I will stop talking because I need to focus to write something. Let's see, am I streaming? Yes, I'm still streaming, still nobody watching. This is awesome. Hey, glad you are watching this. This is my first live streaming. Let me know how am I doing. I'm really, oops, streaming. I'm really curious to know if this is something you would enjoy or not. Okay, back to writing. Again, the entire point of this live stream is that I have to write this article. I have to write it anyway. So I thought, why don't I show you exactly how I do it so that you can also write something that ranks on page 1. Easy. Yeah? Whoop. I'm tempted to start with you, because when readers read you, they are immediately drawn into the content. I'm using Grammarly to spot all these typos, and sometimes it corrects even my grammar, which is useful because I'm not a native speaker, so sometimes I get things wrong, like cotton candy. I think it's cotton candy, but I'm not entirely sure. So what I'm going to do, yes, that thing is cotton candy on my book, and I'm right. So it is so wide that from far it looks like a cotton candy. But obviously, it's not. No need to say that, right? So we just put the hook there. We say, as you walk closer, details come to life and you start noticing that it's not pure white. It is marble, yes, but there is more than that. And we hope at this point that the reader will click the read more button if they are in the facts page and come to read the page. If they come from search, I don't care because Google will direct them directly to the page. Okay, so now they click on the read more button and they're here. So what do I say in the first paragraph after the read more? You see that I'm not copying any of the pages I visited. I'm not doing that. I didn't even read. There is some piece of information, it was on this other page here, which was good, which was this is good, it's good info, so I will use it somewhere. Just copy it here. What is mortar exactly? It's this building thing. Now, I want to check one thing because they say that the limestone should be lighter than marble. Because if I make an argument about that, I need to be sure that I'm not just bullshitting. So limestone density gram, whatever. I don't care how you give me. Sandstone 265. the same. It's the same. So we can't really say that the limestone is lighter than marble, right? I have the feeling that it's kind of the same material. Yeah, it can be a little lighter, but maybe it's more flexible. Yes, this I can believe. By the way, I'm thinking, I'm an engineer, so that's why I'm thinking like this. A little bit of information. Tower of Pisa is mainly made this together. I'm lazy in typing, yeah. Oh. The tower is not the only monument in have to fix. Sorry, ignore and make it. Yep. And here, bright square of miracles. There is only this square of miracles. To be built out of marble. In fact, also the nearby cathedral and baptistry, I know that this is written wrong, are made of the same type of stone. Cathedral. Or nearby, I can't type anymore. Baptistry. At the time of built, the time when this monument were built, material were not an issue, and so was labor. Pisa was in fact a very powerful city with a strong naval fleet. I think it's correct way to say it. Fleet, yes. Is raiding, raiding, sure. to showcase the tremendous power of the little Toscan town. Now we go in the second paragraph. I like to check from time to time how many characters I have. So I already have 680, that's insane. Okay, I have all these things that I have to remove. Yeah. And now we are getting to that. So it's not entirely made of marble. Now, here is written where. What is. So. I will move this up because we are talking right here of raiding towns. So here given the abundance of resources reaching coming to Pisa. Most of the monuments at the time were built reusing the materials brought from the ships. Building materials harvested in foreign lands and brought to Pisa by its ships, right? And this sentence now make no sense. I will fix it. Abundance of resources coming to business. So this I don't need. I will just kill it. Most of the monuments at the time were built reusing the building materials harvested in foreign lands and brought to Pisa by its ships. Okay, makes sense. Given the abundance of this foreign material, local marbles were seldom used. The white marble of Carrara, nearby city, is an exception. Asia due to its staggering white color. Pure white color is strong. What my book I write was in next year. Carrara marble mines or caves. Is it mine or a cave? It's mine. Let's see. Marble mine caves. Mine this marble cave. Ask Google. Yes, then what did I write? Yeah. Quarries, of course it's quarries. Quarries. I like quarries. That's the right term. Carrara marble quarries are still active and the white stone that comes out of it is much appreciated all over the world, so to make it one of the most expensive construction materials around. And so now we say among, not here, up there, we say that the stones used to build the tower came from many different locations on the Mediterranean Sea, including Africa, Greece, and Turkey. Is there something more? Nope. Okay. I know you can be, probably you are bored as hell in this part, but don't quit it, because in the end I'm going to check for keywords. I'm going to see if the keyword density is okay. I know the keyword density is not even a thing anymore, but I have this way of writing that it works, and it somehow as a cross-check on keywords. I think that is very important in this process, and you don't want to miss that. So maybe you want to put this video, like, play it faster or just skip to the end. But don't quit it, just see the end of the story, okay? Now, it's not entirely made of marble. we talk about expensive, so we go back to the we just link this concept, and we say that apparently marble was expensive even at the time the tower was built. So they used limestone to build all the parts that were not visible. While this was probably an attempt to save precious material for some other stunning construction, using limestone instead of marble might have contributed to save the Leaning Tower from collapsing. Is not about weight. The two types of rock weight almost the same. In brackets, but limestone is more flexible, and the fact that mortar was used to keep the limestone together gave the tower just enough flexibility to withstand the forces the internal forces generated by the lean. All right, so starts to come up, almost done. It's 1 hour 20. Oh, we'll make it in 2 hours. Yes. the tower was built using collapsed. Let's put a power word. Disastrous, and result in a disastrous collapse, huh? Like that. If the tower is built entirely out of marble, it probably would have broken in two or more pieces a long time ago, resulting in a disastrous end for this fine monument. Boom. Last paragraph. This I can kill. So now I have it. I have 800 words. Look at that. Wow, not bad. You have to be able to make up stories even if you don't have the material and the information. Just don't invent, make it plausible, use side information you have, a little bit of your personal knowledge, a little bit of fantasy, and now we're talking of restoring its original look. So marble doesn't do well with pollution. This type of rock, I have it here, type of rock, this I can kill, I use it already. This type of rock is famous for its patterns, but when exposed to smoke and nowadays polluted air, it tends to become gray and it loses its natural beauty. This is a problem. And some city just do not take action on it and let their buildings and monuments go gray. Pisa decided to invest in restoring the original look of its monuments, and millions of euro were spent to restore the marble facade of the tower and the other buildings in the Square of Miracles. With the smoke, and nowadays polluted. I'm not sure. Nowadays, it's like this. Yes, some cities just cities. Capital. Okay, almost done. Works took several years and resulted in many ruined photos. In many photos, being ruined by the scaffolding around the tower. However, today there is no restoration work going on the tower, and one can visit it in the tower, and one can visit it and admire its beauty as it was 850 years ago. As clean as it Okay, I'm a little tired now. It should work. Going to 1 hour and a half. It should work. I still miss pictures. I miss a bunch of things. What I want to do now is to copy all the text. I'm going to do the keyword check. I go to wordcounter.net here. I will just copy everything and paste it in here. So this tells me that I have 658 words, which is more or less okay. This my target was 700. There is no grammar mistake, nothing red except this that I don't care. And now, what I like about this is that it tells me one the reading level. I made it a little bit too complicated. I usually like to stay between 9th and 10th grade because I need people, really every kind of people, to be able to read this thing. Probably I made some complex sentences. Shouldn't do that. But what I really like is this. So I'm not counting the percentage of keywords here. What I'm checking is there any word that stands out of the bulk of words? Okay, so I have basically tower, marble, white. You see this? This is built even, it's relevant. These are appearing more frequently in my text compared to other words, and this is exactly what I want to see. I don't care how many times they appear. I don't care if it's four or three or five. This is not what I'm checking when I talk of keyword density. I just want to see that marble is up because that's what we are talking about, right? And then built, it's important because we are talking what is made of. Made of is built, right? So white marble, that's the answer. Okay, now this is one by one. Now let's check it in couple of keywords. They have this neat feature here. Click here, and you see we have square miracles. I'm using 3 times. Tower built, I use 4 times. And then here, ha ha ha, white marble, I use only 2 times. You see? And this I don't like. I want this to be higher. I want to use this once more. So I need to put this once more in the text to make it stand out. Okay? Because at the moment it doesn't. Pure white. So one, I have to add my white marble. Let's check the by three thing and let's see if there is any other addition I should make. So twice, restoring original look. Its original look. And then all the other triplets are appearing only once. So I need to make at least one triplet appear twice or 3 times. So first, let's go and write white marble once more. Yeah, where do I put it? Yes, it is white marble. Boom. Now I picked even the bottom here. Kill this. So we added one word, yes, and the white marble went here. So you see now it's what is article about? It's tower bill, square of miracles, and white marble. So we know what we are talking about. It's leaning tower, what is built of. And now I come back here and see has anything changed? No, it has not. Let's scroll the article. Let's see if I can put a triplet somewhere. Would be nice to have it in the first paragraph. What is the Leaning Tower of Pisa made of? Leaning Tower of Pisa, Tower of Pisa made. This I should have. Oh, this I cannot put this here. I'm saying that it's not pure white. Damn. I hope I start noticing that it's not pure white. Okay, I will have to. No, I want to use this to marble. Need to find another place where to put marble. And now I would like to use a Tower of Pisa made of twice, huh? So what is the Tower of Pisa made of? Oh, let's see if it works. It is if the Tower of Pisa was made out of marble entirely, let's reverse it. So it's not is, is was, but let's see if we get the same result. Some text. Tower Pisa made. Bingo! So we brought this up, and so Google should now understand with that you're talking what made, what Tower Pisa is made of, and we're talking white marble, we're talking square miracle, so this is really, really relevant for the search query. So boom, this we have. Now let's go to the finishing part. I'll save it. Been working. Are you guys still there? Still me? I don't mind that. Meantime, let's go check. No, let's not check nothing here. Did we crash? No, this thing is still working. We did not crash. So Now, I have to fix a few things. I want to embed the tweet, and I have a class for that. Here. The Leaning Tower of Pisa is not made out of marble only, and I will put this in the middle, make it like this one, so I can see it. And just go here and put a class which is click to tweet. Click to tweet. So this makes this thing tweetable. Here, the Leaning Tower of Pisa. Was made out of recycled marble. I like this. So we center this. Again, it looks like I'm wasting time, but the engagement I have of 30 minutes comes from these little details. People like this shit, you know? So let's give it to them. Update. Now, I think I'm fine. What I want to do, I want to change the pictures, because so now we're talking on marble. I want to put some picture of the quarry. These are all free pictures. Note that here I have used this filter label for use with modification, so I'm not going to modify that much, but I'm gonna, so just get this, save image as, and this I will rename properly. This is very important, pay attention. Leaning Tower Pisa, and this is marble quarry, Italy. Carrara. This Carrara. Okay, so this is the name of the image, so that if somebody is looking for this marble, they can find my image, and this would be awesome, right? So this goes here. I want to give this image a little bit more horizontal look, so I'm gonna open it, I'm gonna crop it. I know this is painful, but we need to do that, really. It's very important to have correct and nice looking images. Now here, colors, let's adjust the levels a little bit more, black a little bit more, white. I think it's really white, and something like this. Yeah, it's better than the original. Okay. So now the size, edit. Resizer, so I can make this, it's very stupid size. Make it, let's leave it like this. I won't resize it. So quality, I want to make it 75. Okay, so now I save it. Yes, this is one image. Then another image, I need the Leaning Tower, and need like a Leaning Tower white. Let's see what we find with that image. Boo, it's no stuff, no good stuff. Yeah, this is quite good, but it's not big enough. So again, I need to make sure I use label for use with modification. I want a large size. It's not much. This, it's huge, but I have an idea. I can use this for the thumbnail. Look how nice it looks. Save as Leaning Tower of Pisa. Is a huge image. Oh, no, it's not. Good. Took the thumbnail. I like it. I need anyway to resize it. Let's first check. Is it 16:90? Okay, crop. Maybe the colors a little bit adjusting. See. These things are really important when you work on your craft, because people like images and you want really to get it right. You can't overlook this. Resize, resample. This has to be 250 for my thumbnail. Boom, and now I save it. With quality 72 is fine. Save. Yes, please overwrite that thing. So I'm gonna close this. I'm gonna close this, and that I'm still streaming. Good to know. Now I could. Actually, this image is cool. Think I take okay. Is this 960? Yeah, so I'm gonna keep it like that. Maybe colors, just levels. No, nothing much to do, just leave it like this. Okay, so now I need to duplicate this. I need to upload the pictures. I still miss the header, the top picture, Gonna find it. Guess I have to use one of those I have already. So I will close this and go in the media manager. Again, I'm using Joomla, you are using probably WordPress. You go where it is that you have to go to upload your image. Control panel. And media manager. So here I'm gonna go in articles and in thumbnails, gonna drop the thumbnail. Get the path here. I'm gonna go here in image and links and copy this here. And then I'm not gonna do anything with this because I still don't have this image. I can save in the meantime. And I need to upload the other images. So we have this and this, which I'm gonna use inside the article. Now this is small. I was hoping it was bigger. Least for now. So save. Now what I want to do, I want to go on publishing. I want to set start publishing at yesterday. Today. Oops. Create date I put today, so that it is ordered correctly, sorted correctly. Yes, then I should here I have to change marble build. This is for internal use, no, nothing to do with ranking, just for related articles. And now I will I need to put something in the media description. Let's go with this. How many words are this? 282. Now you should know that the meta description has been upgraded to about 300 words. So we can use 286. This should be quite relevant. Should spend more time on the meta description, but for now I want to publish it, so let's see. Then I will optimize it later. So this we have content published, and this is category is what a what question. Now I'm going to put a couple of images. Here we put the image of the excavator. I name it wrong. I have to rename this. I have no link right now, so it's okay. Yes, so refresh. Carrara marble. Oh, we have it. This I want to put. Okay, so the dimension is has to be center top, just zero. I leave it like that. And I want the style. I want weight 100%. But max width has to be 950 pixels. Insert. Boom. And here I put the other image. Same center 0 and width 100% and max width 950 pixels. I think was it 950? Yes, 960. Okay, insert. I'm gonna check how does it look like. I'll save it. As I save, it should appear in facts. Whew. I didn't put an internal link, should do that. Well, it's 2 hours. Should be in the bottom because it has no views. What is the Leaning Tower of Pisa made of? Read more. Error displaying the error page. This is funny. What? This. Oh boy, what happened? Okay, I have it. Ooh. You see, this is the tweet. If you click here, you go on Twitter to tweet it. It's already made. And here we have the gallery with these are photos from tourists that I get from my Facebook page. And we have this. Canoe still active today, so yeah, restaurant Jean-Luc, blah blah blah. They want to know more. Well, nice article, yeah. Doesn't look very long. But anyway, so internal links, the last thing I'm gonna do and then I'm gonna publish it. Bear with me a little bit more. Let's go after 2 hours. So we are here. Open it again. Oh, again, this thing. What is that? Never seen that before. Disappointing, huh? Error, displaying the error page. I don't want an error page. I'm looking for my own page here. Very, very, very funny. Well, this is disappointing that I've been working 2 hours and now for some reason I have this stupid error showing up. And it's the first time ever, 6 months, never happened before. Why do you want to display an error page? Should put the sounds up, I can barely hear you. Hey, thanks. Let's try to put the sound up there. How do you do that? This is Max. Well, I should speak in the microphone like this. After 2 hours, yes. But another problem is that the entire thing here is screwed up. I don't know what's happening. Cookies. Let me try to just kill all the cookies. Remove. Done. Boom. No, I still have this error page, and I don't know what it is. Can you try going on the page leaningtowerpisa.com and see if you get an error as well? I'm talking to Alexis now here that is watching the streaming. gonna try another of my websites, andreabronzini.com. This is a server thing. The entire server is down. Jesus Christ. Really? Server is down. Come on. What about Katus? Entire server is down. Okay. What to do? First time a live stream, you see? It's impossible. Come on. Server is down. All my websites are down. Great. Okay, try again. Maybe they fixed it. No, they haven't. Let me see if I can post this stream. Can I post the streaming? I don't want to stop, like really stop. I would like to fix this thing. I would like to fix this thing. Yeah, call your provider and shut them live, yes. So next step would be, we said to make the links, but I don't have access to the server, so I cannot do that. Oh, it's back. Jesus. I hope it stays back. So, fax, let's do this quickly. Components, content, articles. That's faster. They must have made a restart or something like that. So I want to put some links. So here goes, when was the Lean Tower Pisa built? Content, tower facts, when? And when was the Lean Tower Pisa built? Title, when was the Leaning Tower of Pisa built? Target the same, I guess. Insert. Then let's go down. In the end, I have mentioned 800 years. So this is how old is the Leaning Tower. Stay with me that now I'm gonna publish this thing. We see how it ranks, like immediately. How old is the Leaning Tower Pisa? How old is the Leaning Tower of Pisa? Insert. Saving the tower from collapsing. We can put this. How did they fix the Leaning Tower? Well, why not? Similar topic. How? the Leaning Tower stabilized? Okay. How did they save the tower from collapsing? How did they save the insert? Boom. Okay, now I made some links. I am totally ready. It's published already. It's public already. I save. And I'm gonna have to make a couple of checks. So I take the link. This is also very important that you take the link, you go on the Twitter validator, card validator, and you make sure that if you share it on Twitter, you actually get something good. I mean, there must be an image and everything. Yes, so the card is correct. And you do the same with Facebook. So you go on the debugger tool, developers.facebook.com/2/debug, and just paste the URL and debug it. And yes, you get something. Takes the picture from somewhere else in the gallery, but I don't care at the moment, so just it's working. So I can just kill this, and now the important thing we have to do, we have to come on Search Console, we have to tell Google that there is an article, new article, and they have to index it. If we don't do this, it will take forever for Google to find. So we go on crawl, fetch as Google, we paste in here the URL, and make sure you kill everything, you remove the domain. Then you want to make it mobile, because now Google has the mobile first index, and then you make fetch and render, and then you wait like till tomorrow, because this thing is gonna be pending for the longest time. Well, so I'm wrapping up. I hope that you kind of enjoy this thing. Let's go back here. So this was my search before I was publishing my thing, and so I have, I think I'm nowhere on page one. Yes, so I'm not on page one. Let's see if I'm on page two. Yeah, I'm the first on page two here. So I am in position 11. And now we are indexing this new article, and let's see, it's still pending here. Let's see if it gets immediately on page one, or where is that is gonna end. Again, the entire point of this 2 hours streaming was to build something that ranks on page one. So if you followed me doing this step by step, you should have understood most of the process I'm using. Of course, every time is different. It depends on what is ranking already. It depends on which keywords you are going after. This, I would say, was pretty easy one, because there was basically no match. Nobody has an article like this on this very topic. And yeah, so we'll see when I manage to get this out of pending and I can index it. Usually it's fairly quick to index, because I don't know, kind of Google trusts my website now. But this, it's really bothering that it takes so much time. So a last look. One thing I want to do, I want to go, oh no, sorry, to do it sumo like this, and oh, now I have to log in. Good luck with that. I don't remember. Boop. I won't do it then. So let's go back to here. Yeah, request indexing. Look at that. So you click here, you go scroll this URL and its direct links, very important. You are not a robot. And go. So now Google is indexing this page. And now what we have to do, we have to go back and do the search again and see where we stand. All right. So this page I don't need. I will just copy this and open another tab so we can make a comparison. Boom. Of course, I don't know if it is indexed already. I'm not here. Might take a bit to index it. Still not here. And again, there is like 888,000 pages that satisfy this query. Now I'm so optimistic that I'm looking my page on page number one here among the first 10 results. I am very optimistic, right? But I mean, I have reason to be so optimistic. Why not? Nope. Let's try page number two. It's still not changed. My best bet is that it is not indexed yet. Check in here. Hey, we have Ron now. Hey, Ron. Website is doing well. I think soon about 1K per month. Yes, of course, I plan to make money. All right, so let's go back and see if this thing finished the indexing. Boom. Still don't see it. It could be in page number 200. Usually, it doesn't work like that. Usually, I nail it pretty well. What the Leaning Tower is made of? What the Leaning Tower is made of? Well, there is a way to check if the page has been indexed. It doesn't help you to say, to tell you where it's ranking. So, but now I'm gonna try at least to see if it has been indexed. Yeah, who? And this was there even before. It's a nonsense that this page ranks before the other, because the other is specifically made to answer this query, so it has to rank before. Now, do the last test, and then now we do this. We will just search everything that is indexed on my website. So site, leaning tower pisa.com, and this gives me all the pages which are indexed at the moment by Google on my website. And so we are boom. Where, when, I'm looking for what. Nope, it's not indexed yet. You see, it's not here. Yep, not indexed. So I guess we have to wait a little bit. Oh, there is another thing I can do to push it, if I really want to push it, which is to go on Google Plus. This is another trick for indexing pages. So you go on Google Plus and you just, oh, sorry, I need the URL. You just take, come on, the URL, and you share it on Google Plus. And just wait to load. I hate that it takes from the gallery, but now it's like that. Boom. And now it should index it, because I've done it on Search Console, and now I've done it even here. So sorry, I'm a little bit lost. Where is Search Console now? I must have closed it. Yeah. Where, when? Still not. Again, I'm very optimistic. It might take days to index it, but usually it really does it in minutes. And again, now that I'm live streaming, of course it doesn't work. So we have seen the server crashing, Google not liking my website. About 23 results. What is the Leaning Tower of Pisa made of? So no way, it is still not indexed. Sorry guys, that this time Google is very slow. Just getting rid of this. Kind of tired being doing this for 2.5 hours. I think the longest time I spent writing an article is 5 hours. Now this didn't have much edit, I just wrote it and published it because I don't want to wait, make you wait forever. Usually I do it in 2 days. I write on the first day, I just draft it, and then I revise the entire thing on the next day. But this was kind of a proof of concept I wanted to give you. All right, there's no way. No way. Google is slow today. Really happy about it. still 23 results, so I guess nothing happened. Now 22. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah, okay, I know that I've been querying the same thing quite much. Oh, come on. Roads, click. All the roads you want me to click? You ever done this? It's crazy. Yeah, this verification. Road. 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 Kanye road. That's not a road. Verify. Submit. Like double verification. Damn it. Okay, kind of giving up. I really need a coffee, you know. It's not indexed. Okay, I want to give it a shot. I wait 5 more minutes. I keep it live. I go have a coffee and I come back in 5 minutes, okay? Yeah, let's see if it get indexed. Be back. I got the coffee. Let's refresh this thing. It's not indexed yet. So make sure that the website is up, because before it was like having some problem. Yes, website is up. It's T23, so oop. Jeez. Yeah, now this came up, but it's totally irrelevant. I'm wondering how long can I live stream? Again, I've never done this, is the first time, so I'm just curious. Can I live stream for like 10 hours? No idea. This was Webmaster Tools, yes. Yeah, this is correct. There's no mistakes here. I really don't know what's going on with Google. Sleeping. 23. Not indexed. You know, not one time this thing happened. Usually it indexes it like 2 minutes. Boom, boom, boom. Anyway, this is the best practice. You gotta do it like this, because otherwise Google will never find you. And now, ironically, it doesn't find me either. Okay, I'm gonna stop this. Come on, give me a break. Now, what we can do? I could stop right now the live streaming, come back in 1 hour or so, and start it again to show you how it's ranking. Because at this moment, I don't think it's gonna happen anytime soon. Really. Marble. Oh, look at that. Straight answer, yeah. But I'm not indexed yet, so I'm just fooling around here trying to kill some time. Side. Pizza.com. Oopsie, miss R. 23. Okay, I'm gonna stop the live stream. I thank you, Ron and Alexis, for watching this, and all the other people that will come later to watch the video on YouTube. And it was kind of cool experience to live stream this thing. And again, since I'm writing articles anyway, it is just fun to live stream it for once. Really sorry that this thing didn't play out, the indexing and the problem with the server, like all together. Maybe the two things are related. Yeah, it could be that this server problem just would add some trouble crawling the website. Can be, but I will try again later, and I will start another stream to show you where it's ranking. Okay, so for now, let's keep this thing and let's catch up again next time. Ciao.